Now the same problem can be solved by another method. Okay? And as I told you, that method here would have given you a quicker result. Okay? But for that, we'll have to understand how that method operates. Okay? Like this method, like the method that we have used right now, the method that I'm going to tell you, that also is a method to add two vectors, but in a different way, not through vectors. Okay? So it is something like this. Now what happens is this. If I have two vectors, okay, say vector A and vector B, such that they are co-initial. If they are not co-initial, you shift them parallel to themselves, same length, and we know they are free vectors. Okay, free vectors are what? Free vectors are when you shift them parallel to themselves, keeping the magnitude the same, and the vector does not change. So if I shift this here, this also remains a vector. Understand that? So, and their magnitudes are given by, magnitude of A is A without the vector sign. Magnitude of vector A is A. Magnitude of vector B is B. Okay? Let this angle be theta. Now, if I draw a parallelogram here, with these as the sides, with these vectors as its sides, then this is how it should look, right? And this angle will remain theta because these two lines are parallel. And this length or this vector still remains A. If I'm talking about this vector, whose length is A, okay? Now, what is the length of this? What is the length of this? A cos theta? Is it not? This is A cos theta. And what is the length of this? This is A sin theta. What is the length of this? If this vector is B, this length is B, okay? Now, if you see, what is my resultant vector? Which vector is the resultant? The vector A plus B or B plus A, since it is commutative, or you could say A, vector A, and I shift this vector there, then this becomes B. How do I add two vectors? Head to tail. So these are arranged head to tail. So the resultant becomes this vector. I call this the resultant vector. I say that this angle is phi. Is phi. The angle that this vector makes with B is phi. Now how do I find out the length? See, If this point is A, this is B, this is C, this is D, this is E, then ACE, triangle ACE is a right triangle. Okay? Is a right triangle. And what happens in this right triangle? Here AC square is equal to AE square plus CE square. AE is what? B plus A cos theta whole square, and C is A square sine square theta. C square is that. If I expand it, I get B square plus 2AB cos theta plus b square cos square theta plus a square cos square theta plus a square sin square theta. If I take out a square common, it becomes cos square theta plus sin square theta, which is 1. So it ultimately becomes b square plus 2ab cos theta plus a square, and that is a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. Get that? So ac is root over this. Get it? So my r resultant vector r has a magnitude of r is given by this, which is a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. Fine. But the trouble is, r is not a scalar, it is a vector quantity. So and merely giving the the magnitude does not solve my problem. Where is the direction? So I'll also have to give phi, and you can see from the same right triangle that tan phi is equal to a sine theta divided by a cos theta plus b. Correct. Why did we do all this? What do you mean? I didn't get you. Why did we do all this? If you know this, it's fine. Now, if A is equal to B, what happens? What happens if A is equal to B? If A is equal to B, then what happens? Then tan phi becomes A sine theta divided by a cos theta plus a, which is a sine theta divided by a into cos theta plus 1. This is equal to a into 2 sine theta by 2 cos theta by 2. That into 2 cos square theta by 2. A cancels, 2 cancels, this becomes tan theta by 2. Now what does that mean? It means that tan phi is equal to tan theta by 2. It implies that phi is equal to theta by 2. Theta by 2. What does it mean? It means that if two vectors are equal in magnitude, then the resultant bisects the angle between them when they are co-initial. Correct. So when we have two vectors of equal magnitude, then the resultant bisects the angle between them. And which angle? When they are made co-initial and the smaller angle between them. Okay. When the other two vectors are co-initial and the angle we are talking about, and the angle is the smaller
and the angle is the smaller angle between the two.
Correct. That's what?
Okay.
Now, if you apply this concept, and there is another thing that becomes very simple, but I do not ask you to use it right now. This formula is sufficient. Don't take it as another special case. When A is equal to B and theta is equal to 120, what will happen? What has happened? I know that this is symmetrically placed. These are symmetrically placed. So all these angles are how much? 120. And they are equal in magnitude. Why? Because this Q and this Q are the same. So these are equal vectors. Now if I put B is equal to A here, then this becomes 2a square plus 2a square into cos 120. What is the value of cos 120? Minus half. So it is 2a square plus 2a square into minus half, which is 2a square minus a square, which is a square root, which is a. Now look at what happens if two vectors are equal in magnitude and they are separated by an angle of 120 degree, their resultant becomes equal to either of them. Is it not? The resultant will become equal to either of them. So if it is, say, something like this, okay, and there, this is the angle. So what happens when this shifts? It becomes this. This is 120, so this is 60. So you know, and this is equal to this. So this is the resultant. These two angles will be equal. Is it not? Because this is equal to this. So it becomes an isosceles triangle, and this is 60, so they become 60. So actually what happens? It becomes this. This and this vector added give you this vector. You can also go by parallelogram law, then also it will be the same thing. Correct. So, do we understand? Now, if you bring this, then this becomes an objective question. Why? The resultant of this is the same magnitude as this and bisects it. So, what becomes the resultant? This becomes the resultant. Our resultant becomes this. It bisects 120, so it makes 160 here. If this is 60 and this is 120, then they fall in a line. And this length is the same as this. And pointing in the opposite direction, sum them up, they'll give you zero. Correct. Two equal vectors at 120 have a resultant that is equal to either of them. And if you sum them, this is and the resultant actually bisects the angle. So this is at 60, this is at 120, this is equal to this. They are in opposite direction, equal magnitude. Sum them up, they become zero. Understand? So all that we did in the last chapter need not be done if you understand this. Okay?